Freedom! Freedom!
Hurrah! Hurrah!
Oh! YecchyBird. No, piss off. Sure. I don't want everyone. Let the boys have some sleep. They'll stop to do tomorrow. It's that piece of shit Colonel. Yes, it's him that I want. The red one that comic would do too. Yes, you'll do. You, the asshole driving around in our car, killing my boys. You, motherfucker, listen to me. So you keep driving around looking at how we live. So how do you find it? You probably think that we are tyrants, beasts even. And you are some kind of hero, are you, huh? Liberating the oppressed with that cube, the witch. But I see you are not a complete idiot. So you do understand, deep down. You do understand. There is no other way. Man is a beast. A beast! You just let a man run free, and it's a murder spree. Remove the restraints of power and law, and everything turns to the law of the jungle. It's always a bloodbath. A total bloodbath. There must be power. Must be law and order. Belief. Civilization. Don't you see? Because without law, without God, everything is permitted. When they bring a new slave in, it's a total disaster. They live in fucking caves now. Forgot everything. What do they get? Life and a hungry ape. A bunch of sickly kids and a death in a demon's stomach. That's it. I give them purpose. They work. They serve. They build. They build a civilization. And you want to destroy it, you motherfucker. Destroy my civilization. You piece of shit. Fuck you. You get what I mean. Keep that car while you can.
Where the hell is Saul, the cretin? Driving around, I guess. When did I even give him a car? I don't remember. I shouldn't have. That man's an idiot, a complete cretin.
I'll put
that double sitting in my castle. Decoy in the castle while I'm here. How long do I have to rot here for? To hell with this plan.
I'll have to ask you to put that weapon away. You see, the guards are getting nervous,
They'll take out the double, but the Baron will be fine. Well, why would you even let them? Why the hell did I agree to this plan? He's a cretin. Why did I listen?
Don't remember.
They even paint portraits of that double, those cretins. And I must rot here. Damn you, Saul. I can't take this anymore. I'll tell him. I'll give him a piece of my mind. Guards, as soon as Saul arrives, bring him to me. I want to see that cretin.
Listen up, everyone! Yeah, fuck off already! You train motherfuckers! Aren't you getting too fucking full of yourself? Didn't your mommy tell you it's wrong to take other people's stuff? The drivers of the ship were ours! Our property! You ain't fucking crossed the line this time, you dumb motherfuckers! You're out of control and you will be put in your place! Stepper, no! Come over here! We have an operation to discuss! This shit is getting out of hand. Hey, look, I would wait until the rest of the boys return from the raid. But we're out of options. The new gang is off the rocker and has to go down.
Thank you. It all happened so fast. We didn't even have time to abort and load. Storm wasn't even that strong at first, but
nothing on the air. Nothing to listen to.
We started adding more mooring lines.
Just a fucking baron ranting again.
Yeah, it kinda died down by the moon.
Oh, fuck! Don't shoot! Don't shoot, man!
And then while we were running about,
wait a minute. Are you one of the newcomers? The ones with the train? I'll be dead. Hey, come on in. Make yourself at home, brother. I don't get many guests with all the spiders around. They packed a hold full of the Baron's flunkies' bones already. Oh, you must be real lucky to have gotten here in one piece. When I had to run from the gang, I hid here and spent ages watching the damn critters. I thought I was a goner. But it turned out they were afraid of light, so I settled here for good. Now I make my living by collecting the guns and gear from the idiots the spiders catch, and they don't mind. Then in my free time, I just scan the radio, so I know pretty much everything that's going on around these parts. These bandits blabber about everything on air. Then again, there's nobody to eavesdrop. Slaves don't have radios. So, as soon as they noticed your train, the Baron got all his people running around in circles. He thinks you're here to take him out. Now, you tell me if that Baron is all right upstairs. Certainly looks completely insane to me. A classic case of persecution complex and delusions of grandeur. Say someone did come to take him out. Real classy, like driving a fucking train. Fine, let's give him that. But why would they stop at the old station then, huh? They could stop the train right at the castle gate and have at him. But logical thinking is not among Baron's faults. He's too grand for that now, huh? Which will turn out to be his undoing in the end, I think. I will say, though, that if you really do take that Baron bastard out, the whole desert will be kissing your footprints until the end of days. Not to mention my personal thanks. Well, I've been ranting for too long. Have some rest. Use the workbench if you like. In general, make yourself home, as I said. I'll stay on the radio in the meantime.
For a reason.
Baron's compliments. In fact, for loyal service. And the Baron does not give presents like they're nothing. You got to have authority to be worthy. Thus, everybody knows who's to blame. The newcomers. They're definitely going for the Baron. For some reason, though, they decided to start with Saul. So, what I wanted to say is, if you happen to have this car now, watch out. All the bandits know it, and will open fire as soon as they see you driving it. They won't even try asking first. Thanks, man. You really don't need a gun at the ready here. Personally, I think that Saul got his just desserts here. He's as much of a bastard as the Baron is. Just more of a loser.
Yes.
Radio chat I eavesdropped on here. Was that you who freed those slaves? I see it in your eyes. A job well done. Pointless, though. The bandits already caught half the runaways, and most of the others came back by themselves. You can't get far in the desert when you're butt naked, even if you don't encounter any mutants. So what was I... of course. There were other liberators before. It always ended like this. The prison is not just ditched.
up, everyone! The Baron is about to speak! Listen up, everyone! The Baron is speaking!
We're going to have a grown-up conversation here, gentlemen. So move your tribals away from the radio. That? Good. It has come to my attention that Sheldon told people that I should not have burned Sweaty, and that Sweaty was an okay guy, and I overreacted over some stupid shit we intended for the tribal. Who cares if he's gone wrong? We need the slave side, and took a leak into the Holy Flame. Well, I have just put Shell Game down. Nothing could be done about that. Those of you who can go can get remuneration. What? So, to avoid further incidents like this, I gotta tell you people something here. Especially the new ones. Tell me, why do the tribals obey us? Is it because they fear us? It partly is. But fear before man is not absolute. When your life is so shitty you've got nothing to lose, you start having rebellious thoughts, even if you are the lowest of the tribal. And can we have that, gentlemen? No, we cannot have that. That is exactly why tribal must have faith. Worship the Holy Flame. Kill him. It is a loss, but it will undoubtedly pay off. Remember, this is what the Holy Flame wants, what the universe wants. And I want to make sure that we have no more misunderstandings concerning this.
As you were, everyone, the Baron has spoken.